Good afternoon, students. See, yesterday we have learned about the Mendeleev's periodic table. See, in the class we started our new lesson, that is periodic classification of elements. Okay, so in this lesson we have done the study up till 20th. That is, the first one is Tavernier triads, second one is Newland law of octaves, and the third one Mendeleev's periodic table. Okay, so Dmitri Mendeleev was one of the first scientists. He classified all 63 elements in a systematic way in a periodic table. So some characteristics of the Mendeleev's periodic table we have learned yesterday. So today we will see in a detail about how he placed elements in a periodic table. Okay, so see here, Mendeleev's periodic table. Once again we will revise some points. That is, he arranged elements on the basis of atomic mass and a chemical property. See, we discussed before also, so both the scientists, means before also, both the scientists, they arranged the elements according to the atomic masses, and he arranged elements on the basis of atomic mass as well as physical and chemical properties. He selected hydrogen and oxygen and reacted every elements with it and form its a compound. See, so this point, it was remaining yesterday, that we have discussed about the physicals and chemical properties the same. According to that basis, he arranged elements in a periodic table. Okay, so he selected the hydrogen and oxygen, reacted with the every elements. So in a periodic table, see here, in this periodic table, he given the oxides and then which compound will form, which formula will form. Okay, so RO means with oxygen, and RH means with hydrogen, so hydride. Okay, so in the group, see, we have discussed yesterday, the horizontal columns are known as a group. So first, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seven, and eight groups are there, and a seven period. So yesterday also I have told you, so in the periodic table there are six periods. Seventh one, that is a drawback. Okay, so see, this each group is divided into two subgroup, that is A and B. See, you can see in this periodic table also, and see, RO, R means what? Element. So for example, see here, Li is there. So okay, LiO means what? Lithium oxide. Then L oxide, the same for Na also. NaO means sodium oxide, NaH means sodium hydride. So these the chemical properties are same, means which elements are present in a first group. Now for example, lithium, sodium, potassium. Okay, so whatever the elements are present in a first group, their physical and chemical properties are same. Okay, so he explained in his periodic table, and according to a basis of this, he arranged elements in a particular group. Okay, so now see the next point, that is, compounds of hydrides and oxides were treated as one of the basic properties of LiO means what? Lithium oxide. The same for the sodium also. NaH means sodium hydride, and NaO means sodium oxides. Okay, so he compounds of hydride and oxides were treated as one of the basic property of an element for its classification. And see, what is a periodic law? So properties of elements are periodic functions of their atomic masses. See, yesterday also we have discussed this periodic law. Okay, so see now, next point, that is, Mendeleev research was based on the 63 elements that were known at that time. So only 63 elements were known, and he classified all the 63 elements in a periodic table. He studied the relationship between the atomic masses of the element and their physical and chemical properties. Okay, then he studied the formation of hydrides and oxides of the elements and treated this as one of the basic property of an element. Then the periodic table contains vertical columns called groups and horizontal rows called as a period. He placed element that had a similar properties under vertical columns, leaving blanks a space for the elements not yet discovered. So this is the big achievement for in his periodic table. So he kept a place for unknown elements also. Okay, according to this basis, he classified this all 63 elements in a periodic table. See, here is a group. It is based on the atomic weight, and each group up till 7th is divided into two subgroups, that is A, normal element, and B, transition elements. Okay, we have discussed this yesterday. Now, see here, this is actual Mendeleev's periodic table. The same periodic table, it is given in your textbook also. So you can see that groups 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 group, okay, and oxides and hydrides formula also given. R means any element when it reacted with oxygen, then what that RO means, suppose for example LiH means lithium, LiH means lithium hydride, and LiO means lithium oxide. Okay, NaO means sodium oxide. And now see here, in the second group the formula is different, that is RO. Okay, BO beryllium oxide, and RH2 means BH2. Now see MgH2. So this way he kept each and every element in that particular group, those physical and chemical properties are same. Okay, physical properties that we discussed yesterday may be related to boiling point, melting point, and densities. Little means mostly it is similar to each other. So whatever the elements are present in each group, in each row, that chemical properties and physical properties are same. Okay, so now we will see the achievements of time. So see, this is the big achievement. So he kept some place for those elements which were not discovered on that time. Okay, so now you know that now in a modern periodic table there are 118. Okay, but on that time only 63 elements were known. So which elements were discovered after that? See, the gallium, scandium, and germanium. Predict properties of elements on basis of its position. Okay, he predict the properties of elements, that is hydride and oxide, chemicals and physical properties, as well as those are unknown elements, that also the chemical and physical properties and which elements will be discovered, he predicted on that time only. Noble gases which were not discovered later could fit in his table. Okay, so these are the achievements of Mendeleev's periodic table. So these all the points are very important. After this period, you have to write this all the points in your chemistry notebook. Okay, now see, which are the drawbacks and which limitations are there, and because of that reason Mendeleev's periodic table we are not following nowadays. See, modern periodic table we following now also. So what are the limitations of Mendeleev's periodic table? See, the first, that is position of the isotopes could not be explained. Yes, see, in the basic chemistry we have learned about the isotopes, isobars, isotones. Okay, so he not explain about that isotopes. And cases in his periodic table, that is some elements arrangements wrong, that is a cobalt. Now cobalt atomic mass is 58.9. के बिफोर टू निकेल दैट इज 58.7. नाउ सी कोबाल्ट एटॉमिक मास इज मोर देन द निकेल, सो निकेल शुड कम फर्स्ट, बट इन हिज पीरियोडिक टेबल कोबाल्ट केम बिफोर टू द निकेल एंड ही नॉट एक्सप्लेन अबाउट दैट. सो दिस वन इज ऑल्सो लिमिटेशन और ड्रॉबैक ऑफ मेंडेलियव्स पीरियोडिक टेबल. Hydrogen was not assigned correct position. It had properties of both alkali and halogen. See, last time also I given the example that is a lithium and sodium. But before that in first group hydrogen is there. But that hydrogen properties are not similar, means he not explain about the hydrogen. Hydrogen was not assigned correct position. It had properties of both alkali and halogen. Okay, so these are the some limitations of Mendeleev's periodic table. So today our Mendeleev's periodic table, this point is completed. If you have any doubt about the Mendeleev's periodic table, then you can ask me anytime. So today you have to do work that you write this all the points in your chemistry notebook. Okay, so tomorrow we will learn next point. So thank you everyone.